Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and this is a response to a query from one of my friends and a fellow militia member. I was talking to her about her marksmanship, and she was concerned that she wasn't a very good shot and she'd like to get some practice. And I said, well, let me tell you a story about a man named Kevin. Okay, way back in about 1968, 69 or so, I got this Daisy saddle gun. It's an 1894 model. It is a single lever pump action BB gun. I think it holds 30 or 40 or so BBs in the chamber. You have a magazine that you slide a lever down to load the magazine with 10 BBs, and you shoot 10 and you slide it back down and get 10 more. So it's spring-loaded, so you don't have to worry about what direction you're pointing it. It's been a phenomenally good little gun. It doesn't shoot a BB anymore because the rings that push the air are worn out, which is not surprising considering how old it is. So that's where I started. And it shoots BBs. Now, BBs are dirt cheap. Back in the day, I could get, for a nickel, I could get a packet about the size of a 20-gauge shotgun shell. For a quarter, I think I got 500 of them. So, very cheap. And today, let's see, there's 6,000 of them in here, and they're cheap. Very inexpensive. Another nice thing about BBs, at close range, they're quite accurate. And if you have a trap or a target that catches the BBs, you can use them over and over and over again. So your initial investment may be 500 BBs, but if you build yourself a reasonable trap behind your target, you can shoot over and over and over again. Just keep them dry because they will rust. A lot of them are copper coated on the outside. Now they're 1.177 caliber. So they're not nearly as big around as a 22. They don't pack near the power of a conventional firearm. But for practice, for getting used to sights, for getting used to trigger pull and everything, phenomenal. And the nice thing about these, most of them fire slow enough that if you've got light behind you, you can actually see the BB go down range and tell where it's going. So it gives you a better idea of what's going on. You get a lot of practice for very little money. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you some options that I have in this particular area so you can get perhaps a more educated idea what type of practice firearm you'd like to buy. First option I'm going to offer is airsoft. These things are cheap. They can be had for right around $20 bill. They fire a plastic BB at 6mm at any distance beyond about 10 or 15 feet. They're horribly inaccurate. Sometimes you can buy some more expensive BBs for them that are more accurate, but if you want to put a range inside your house or down your basement or down a hallway or something like that, these things are great. There's a simple little trap target that you can buy. The paper target sticks over the front and it's made out of thin sheet metal. The BBs bounce into the back. They're trapped inside of a rag or something that you lay on the bottom, and you can shoot them over and over again until they actually break sometimes. But so 10 or 15 feet, short range, small target, extremely economical. The other thing is they're not lethal to anything except maybe a spider. So you're not likely to do major damage. It's not going to poke a hole in your wall. It's not going to break a window likely. I suppose if you hit a CFL lamp just right, you might break a light bulb. Beyond that, don't shoot somebody in the eye, but excellent source of economical practice. Excellent practice. Once again, helps you to work on your steady hand, and you can see the BB go if you're directly behind it when you shoot. Very, very handy. I like that. Gives you an idea of sight picture a little bit better. And in a future video, I will do a sight picture video to give you an idea where you might want to put them. Now, there's a lot of theories about sights. For every person that goes out to shoot a gun, a firearm, or whatever, they may have a different idea of what they want for a sight picture, and they adjust their sights accordingly. As long as they're consistent about that, that's all that matters. In fact, I don't care if they shoot the rifle or the pistol upside down. If they get the job done, that's their business. So we're not going to argue about sight picture. I do fairly well with mine. Anyway, so there we go. There's another option. Very simple, very inexpensive. Don't get the super cheapy cheapies if you want to have any decent practice with them. Step up a little bit. I think both of these shoot somewhere between 350, 400 feet per second. They're a little bit better. They have a magazine in the bottom that loads, 15 or 20 rounds or whatever it holds. And you shoot them until they're empty, then you load the magazine and shoot them again. You do have to cock them each time. They're not semi-automatic or anything like that. In fact, every one of the options that I'm going to show you today will have to be manually cocked in between each shot. Okay, on to the next one. All right, perhaps the most famous and well-known and all the other adjectives you can use for that, and probably the most popular BB gun of all time is the Red Ryder. It's manufactured by Daisy. It is still manufactured. This is a relatively new one. There's a spot over there at the end of the barrel. You open up a door, you pour the barrel housing full of BBs. And there's an inner and outer barrel, obviously. And you shoot till it's empty, and it holds a lot of BBs, maybe 400 or 500. Reasonably accurate, not very powerful. Not nearly as powerful as my 1894 saddle gun was when it was new. And yet, for short range, especially indoors or whatever, very, very good choice. Has a stock that is nearly full size, not thickness, but lengthwise. So an adult can shoot it, and it's still short enough for most teenagers or older children. 12, 13 year olds will have no problem shooting this one. They do make a model one step down from this for extreme youth, I would call them, 7, 8, 9 year olds. It's all plastic stock fore and aft, and I don't know what the name of it is, but for most adults, it's not going to be long enough. And it doesn't have, well, it might be exactly the same cocking strength and everything, but I think it's a little bit less than this one. I took this one outside and shot it just a minute ago. BBs came out straight. They drop off quite quickly, so you're not going to do damage at a long distance. Break windows, break bottles, yes, indeed it will. But for an indoor target, once again, very, very good choice. And with the lighting behind you, you can still see this BB go. So it gives you the option of actually getting to know your ballistics, so to speak, at the same time you're learning your sight. I lined up on the sight and fired several off into the woods, and the BB tracked nicely with my sighting. So there is a ramp adjustable sight in the back for height. You cannot reasonably adjust it left and right, although I think, you know, anybody with a little bit of finesse can probably push the back sight left or right a little bit and just bend it out of shape if it's way off. But for most shooting at 15 or 20 feet, maybe up to 25 feet, it should be just fine for punch and paper targets. And once again, the BBs can be caught in a trap, and I think you can use the same trap for the BB gun that you do for the airsoft. And I have, and it works very, very well. It's a very simple trap. I think it costs $15 or $20 for the little target trap. And some of them have a net. You don't want the ones with the net. You want the ones that are just a metal trap target. I'll show you how to build a target later on in another video if there's enough interest. I've built gee whiz, dozens of them over the years. You know, the stack of cardboard you shoot into it and then pick them out, that just takes too long to pick your BBs out. So, if you're interested in that, let me know, and I will show you how to build a simple indoor trap target for trapping BBs. Okay, Red Rider, next step up. Now, this is a daisy. I don't think that Crossman has anything that's comparable to this in their line of air guns. I don't think they have a single pump type air gun. So let's move on to our next one. Well, actually, that may not be the case. My M1 carbine here may be indeed a Crossman. I'm not 100% sure because all the data plates and everything I think are missing off of it. But it's it's really not a good choice, but we'll look at it anyway. All right, this is another style of a BB gun. I don't think this is manufactured any longer. I haven't seen them. To cock it, you push the barrel in and pull the barrel back out. There's a spot on top where you drop one BB in at a time. There is a place for a magazine under it, but the magazine is merely just for show, or maybe to hold extra BBs, because it does not load a BB into the BB gun at all. It's not very powerful. The only reason I got it is because I've always liked the design of the M1 carbine, and so there it is, a little 30 carbine. As for a shooter, yeah, it doesn't even have a front sight on this one, so you know, not much power to this one anymore. It was an interesting BB gun in its day, and you know, very well could have been a pretty good little shooter, but it's many years old and had many, many rounds through it. So I've only had it for a couple years, but it's just mostly conversation piece to me. And once again, I don't think it's in manufacture any longer. Okay, our next step up from here is going to be combination pellet rifle, BB rifle combinations. The one in the rear is a Crossman. The rear stock comes off by pushing a button. It snaps off. It becomes a pistol. It's a neat little assault style BB pellet rifle. It shoots one at a time. It does not have a magazine of any sort on it, but very accurate. Built on exactly the same frame as their famous pellet pistol. I'll show you in a few minutes. 10 pumps on it. Cracks that thing out somewhere around between 500 and 650 feet per second. So it's a rock and roll little monster. Very, very accurate. A lot of fun. One or two pumps for indoor use, maybe three. And it'll rip tin cans all day. It is sophisticated enough to hunt small game. I would have no problem shooting rabbits, squirrels, small birds. I don't know that I'd try to put a raccoon down with it, but your smaller varmints, a muskrat with a good, well-placed shot to the head, some of those kind of things, without any problem at all. Very, very good for small varmint. Rats, mice, you know, those kind of things. No problem. And the nice thing is it comes apart, so it's packable. Very, very handy. You have to pump it. And, of course, more than one pump. One pump, a lot of times, it won't get the pellet out the barrel. By the way, if that happens, pump it two or three times and shoot, fire it again, and it'll dislodge the pellet from the barrel. It's not like a rifle with regular powder. All right, the one in front of that, down closest to us, is a daisy. The charging handle is right in front of the trigger. You grab it and you pump it. It takes 10 pumps. The speed, the velocity of the round is about identical to the one above it. Once again, very accurate. That one's easy to pump. I bought that one because I thought it looked sharp. It's got a Monte Carlo stock, and we've ripped a lot of rounds out with it. It's a great little gun, and quite reasonably priced. So that one comes, I believe, also in a 22 caliber, and we'll talk about 22 caliber later. But you can fill the magazine up with BBs and shoot a bunch of BBs without having to reload the magazine, or you can fire one pellet at a time. It's a pretty heavy hitter, and I've shot these at 50 yards on target with very good accuracy. Not with BBs, with pellets, and even with BBs, you have no problem hitting major size targets at 50 yards with these things. 50 feet. I don't know about 50 yards. 50 feet. So 50, 60 feet, no problem at all. I don't know. Probably 30 yards. I probably fired them 30 yards down and across my front yard. That'd be 90 feet. Yeah, shouldn't be any problem at all, 90 feet to hit. You're not going to hit a bottle cap at 90 feet the first time necessarily, but with a little bit of practice, you can sure tear up some targets at that distance. Okay, so we'll move on to the next batch. All right, this one is missing a little piece off the four stock, but it's a 66 model Crossman. They make a 550, a 440, and this is a 660. All of them are inexpensive, built on the same basic chassis, different plastic and whatnot on them. The 440, I think, was one of the very first ones I ever had. Very simple. I mean, it looks like it's got a 2x4 for a front stock. Anyway, a good choice also. Inexpensive on the Crossman side instead of the Daisy side. Okay, the one thing about the 440, the smaller version of this, with that looks like it's got a 2x4 for a front stock. Very inexpensive. It doesn't have a cover over the barrel or anything. They're quite durable. They're a lot of fun. They're quite accurate. So if you want to pump one of these things, it's a very good choice. It's a shorter stock for people that aren't quite as big. So for women that aren't quite full frame, be a pretty good choice. And with three pumps, once again, very, very useful little thing for indoor shooting. And you can use the same trap that you would for a BB rifle. You pump it up to 10 times, I wouldn't shoot it in the house, because that bullet or BB could ricochet and go zippity-doo-dah anywhere in the house. But Crossman makes a full line of very nice, reasonably priced pellet rifles. All right, our next step up in air guns are 22 caliber. And what you see in front of you are two of the same 22 caliber pellet rifle. They are both Crossman. They are both from the same general era. The top one is the less expensive model, and the bottom one is the premium model. They are otherwise very much the same. The bottom one is set up like a premium regular firearm rifle. The top one has a folded front sight and some things, so it's not quite as fancy, and it just has a barrel on top of it, whereas the lower one has a barrel housing over top of the barrel. Both of them unbelievably accurate. 8 pumps to over 600 feet per second, and these things will rock your world. 50 yards, no problem at all with these. You know, lay yourself out, get yourself a good sandbag set up, and punch targets at 50 yards if you want. They are they're very powerful. At 90 feet, I had some old road signs and just beat the daylights out of the old road signs with these. Did not poke a hole in them. So it's interesting to note they're not as powerful by any means as a 22 caliber standard rifle. But they will do the trick. I'd have no problem at all taking nearly any small game here in the United States with one of these. Give it 8 pumps, take a raccoon out of the tree, as long as you make your shot a good one. You're gonna have to hit a vital area. You're not just gonna pop it like you might with a 22 and hope. It's gonna have to be a precisely dealt shot. But you know, if you've been hunting as many years as I have, and if you're as careful about it, should be no problem at all. Have no problem taking squirrels sitting out of trees, sitting rabbit or whatever, pop it between the ears, and it's a done deal. The impact of the 22 caliber pellet is quite a bit stronger than from a 177, although the 177 may travel a little bit faster. It doesn't weigh as much, so it doesn't hammer quite as hard. I'd have no problem, like I say, taking one of these out and taking small game with it. 8 pumps, that's it. 8 pumps is full pop. I guess you could pump 10, but you're just wasting your time. Once you've reached the maximum, all you're doing is just spinning your wheels. And very accurate, very fun to shoot. Sights adjustable in all ways on both, well, the bottom one for sure. The top one looks to me like the top sight is welded to the barrel. So you may not get that. But in any case, these are as old as I am, and they still shoot wonderfully well. I'm not sure if they still make this particular style. I wouldn't be surprised. It's been extremely popular, but you can get them that are very similar and expect them to shoot as well. Crossman makes a very, very fine air rifle, as does Daisy. I'm happy with both of those guns, and they serve me very well. All right, I laid out the whole gambit of pellet pistols here in front of me. Every one of these will shoot pellets. Let's start with the one on the right at the rear, and that is a Daisy Marksman. It's modeled after the M1911. These later models that are all plastic, it's only got a 2-inch barrel. I mean, it's not very accurate. I took it out and shot it a few times. The BB goes up when it comes out of the barrel quite dramatically, so it might frustrate the daylights out of you trying to work with something that some of those. But they do make an aluminum model of these, cast aluminum, fair amount more accurate, once again indoors for short range. Obviously not powerful enough to do any hunting with. You might scare an animal with it, but you're not likely to do it any lethal damage. All right, to the left of that on the top is a Daisy, and it is a single pump, single shot, pellet only pellet pistol. It's designed as a target pistol. It's extremely accurate. The Boy Scouts here in Missouri use these in their ranges to practice marksmanship. It's not a real powerful pistol. I think it fires somewhere between 350 and 450 feet per second on a single charge, but it is very accurate. It's a lot of fun to shoot. It has a thumb ramp on the side. If you're left-handed, it's probably not the pistol for you unless you find a left-handed model. Otherwise, placing your thumb on that thumb ramp and pushing down with your right thumb gives you tremendous stability. It's a great little firearm. It's a lot of fun. Powerful enough to take a bird or a small animal. If you were in a pinch, probably. Get up close, make your shot count, make it a headshot. That's, you know, typically what I'm going to do with one of these anyway. Okay, right below that one is a Crossman, and it is a 177 BB or pellet, one at a time. You load them one at a time, just like the assault rifle that we saw earlier. And okay, same power specs. You put 10 pumps on this thing and it'll rock and roll just like the rifles. Extremely accurate, easy to carry, put it in your backpack, whatever, when you're going out in the woods. Small game, squirrels, rabbits, small nuisance birds, muskrats. Start getting any bigger than that, you know, you're going to think about making your placement of your shot very carefully. But still, I'm the kind of guy, I don't want to mess up any of my meat, so I'm taking it in the ear on almost everything I shoot. It's just the way I've always done. I don't like to pick pellets out of the meat. So, I'm thinking shotgun pellets. I don't like to take shotgun pellets out of the meat either. So, survival pistol, absolutely. If you carried a good 100 or more pellets in your pocket in one of the little cases, or if you had a big pouch of BBs, that thing could easily keep you alive out in the woods. All right. It is 177 also, like I said. Okay, swinging over to the right and on the bottom. Probably the rarest of the whole bunch here, all the ones that I have, that is a Benjamin Franklin 22 caliber pellet pistol. It has the same kind of workings as all the rest of them, but it is 22 caliber, so it does not shoot BBs. It shoots one pellet at a time, and it rocks. It's small, it's easy to carry. It is an air pistol. If it's not cocked, it's not loaded, it's not a concealed weapon in most states. You'll have to check on that, but I think you'll find that it is not, because it's an air pistol. They can be mailed. Pump that thing 10 times, and I would have no problem taking most any small game with it. It's not very heavy, carries well, and it's extremely accurate. In the right hands, that thing is basically lethal. would I use it for home security? Well, you got one shot, and after that, you're pumping, and then you're loading. So, you know, think in terms of black powder rifle, where you got a muzzle loader rifle, and then you say, no. But if you got a possum on the porch that's pretty persistent, it would dispatch a possum without any problem. You know, if you have other varmints that are messing with you, if you have snakes or other things that are causing you problems, any kind of small animals around your place that need to be dispatched, it would work just fine. The thing I like about it is small. It's not very heavy. So we've run the gamut pretty well through my air guns. And of course, I could get into some that I've manufactured over the years, but we'll not do that for now. But any of these would be a good choice for a get started. And of course, if you get the higher quality ones, especially the pistols, like the one on the left, that Crossman, that'll last you a lifetime. And you'll get all the practice you need. It has basically the same sighting that a pistol or a rifle. Excellent, excellent, excellent choice. And it shoots BBs or pellets. Nice to have that option. So in the house with a couple of three pumps, you can shoot targets, or you can go outside and knock a starling down if you've got one that's giving you a lot of trouble. Starling, a dove, you know, any of a number of those small birds, no problem. As long as they're legal in your area, I don't want you to do something you're not supposed to do. Okay, so that's my treatise on this. The next step from this is CO2 cartridge firearms, and I have a couple of CO2 pistols. I've had one since I was in college. I actually have owned it three times. I bought it and sold it and bought it and traded it and bought it back again three times. The only problem I have with CO2 is that over a period of years, the valves go bad in them, and then they're worthless. One of them I have is on a Beretta M9 style frame, and it's, you know, you put your BBs in there, you put your CO2 cartridge in it, every time you pull the trigger, it fires. So you have a little slide lever on the side, a little slide, you slide a magazine full of 10 or 12 BBs, 20 or whatever it holds, and every time you pull the trigger, it fires until it's empty. It's a lot of fun, it's quite accurate, out to 50 or 75 feet, it rocks pretty good. BBs only, and CO2 cartridges are expensive, and of course you don't want to fire CO2 in the house because the CO2 has oil in it too, and it stinks. It's just not my choice for indoors. You really can't change the velocity of that one. My other one is a target pistol that looks very, very much like this top one up here. It looks almost exactly like a Ruger Mark. And but it needs the valve cylinder again. I replaced the valve in 75 or 76. That's 19, 75 or 76. And it needs it again. I don't know if it's available again. Accurate, holy cow. Probably the most accurate of any of mine. But you know, it's not very well shootable without that valve. So I try to stay away from CO2 myself. I have a few of them around here, and they all have the same problem. Eventually, they go to leaking, and then it don't work anymore. Most of these, when they start to wear out, unless they're 50 years old, like a couple of them, you can oil them up. Now, I'm going to give you one caution at the end here. I want everybody to listen to this very carefully. Never, ever, never, ever, never, ever use WD-40 to oil these firearms. Okay, I'm going to say that one more time. Never, ever, never, ever, never, ever use WD-40 to oil these firearms. The rubber O-rings and the cups that cock them, that pump the air up, will shrink and they will no longer function. I learned it the hard way. Don't use WD-40 on your airsoft. Don't use WD-40 on any of your air firing weapons. Not your... what do we call those things? Paintball guns. Just keep it away. WD-40 is a phenomenal product, but It causes the rubber, whatever they're using in these things, to shrink, and then they never fire again. Oil them with a simple 30 weight oil, and they do make 30 weight oil, engine oil type oil in a can, an aerosol type can. There's any of a number of other spray lubricants that are fine. I think REM oil would be fine, but WD-40, whatever it is, that's in there, dries the rubber seals out and they don't work again. Now, is that an absolute? If I sprayed some of these where they live, they might. But I've had enough of them destroyed that I'm not going to trust it to any of these again. Now, come to my regular 22 rifles and my 30-30s and stuff. At the end of the day, I will drown those with WD-40 and just let the stuff run out everywhere. Drown the stock, drown everything. Pushes all the moisture out, cleans everything out. It's wonderful stuff. But not BB and pellet rifles and pistols. Okay? All right. That's a long enough video for today. We're going to get this one in the can and get it out so y'all can see it. Kevin Bacon. Bye for now.